Hi everyone. I'm sure by now you've heard about the death of Gene Hackman and his wife of over 30 years, Betsy Arakawa. And today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about something surprising. The cause of death for Betsy was a silent, kind of deadly health risk that probably many of you have never heard of. It's called the Hantavirus. First of all, I'll tell you, being married to my wife for many years and just thinking, how lonely it is for one of them to realize that his wife had passed away. And it's just tough to think about. As you know, if you any of you who are married or have a partner for a long time, it's really difficult. It's a difficult and sad situation that happened. But let me get into this this hantavirus. A lot of people don't know about it. I think that unless you've had somebody who's been affected by it or you're a clinician or a doctor who's treating it, you may not know about it. But hantavirus is a rare, deadly disease caused by a virus that spreads from rodent droppings, urine, or saliva. And so you're thinking, my gosh, how do you get it, right? So in places like, for example, New Mexico, where Gene Hackman and Betsy Arakawa lived, it can actually be, something that you see. And that's a state where we've seen hantavirus cases. And so hantavirus can be carried by rodents, usually deer mice. And you don't even have to touch the rodents to be able to get infected. And you're in the garage wiping up or cleaning up old droppings. And what happens is that when you do that, you get tiny virus particles in the air, and then when you breathe them in, that's how the infection starts. And Betsy had it infecting her lungs. It was called the hantavirus pulmonary syndrome. So again, pretty sad that this is a relatively rare disease, but it can be deadly. And so important for people who live in states like New Mexico. The problem with hantavirus, it can be a little bit silent, right? In the beginning, you may not have all those symptoms that you think about that make it severe. You could have just like flu-like symptoms, fever, muscle ache, and fatigue, just to start off with. And then it can get further into your body, and you could get something as severe of an illness as she did, and it could take your life. So it's just important to know fever, muscle aches, and fatigue. And then when it gets worse, it can cause severe shortness of breath, fluid buildup in the lungs, and the body struggles to get oxygen. So it starts off kind of like the flu, and you don't know what's going on. A lot of us, now, if you live in the Midwest or many parts of the world, many parts of the country that have the flu, you may just think you have the flu, right? But by the time most people realize something is wrong, it can be too late. There's no cure for hantavirus, no vaccine. And once it starts and progresses, even hospital care might not be enough, right? So it's important. Remember, once symptoms appear, hantavirus has a 38% fatality rate. That's big. It's almost 4 in 10 people who get it don't survive. So it's tough. And so I'm sure Gene Hackman, he probably realized that his wife had passed away. Now you have to remember, Gene was 95 years old, and I've had patients, I've had family members with Alzheimer's. It's I don't even know if he knew that what was going on. I don't know what the degree of his Alzheimer's was, but he was battling Alzheimer's disease as well as heart disease. So after Betsy passed away, we don't even know if we understood what had happened due to dementia. But nevertheless, his weakened heart, failing memory, he died about a week later. And it could be also from the stress and isolation of losing his wife. And I know that the reports say that he had underlying heart disease, but there is something called, dying of a broken heart too, right? So you can have this overwhelming stress and grief that bombards your body. That could also be playing a role. And the bodies were found, days after they were they had passed away. Their lifeless bodies were found, which is really, really surprising to me that nobody called them or checked on them more often. But it is what it is. I mean, that's what happened with them. So how do you protect yourself from I'll talk a little bit about Alzheimer's, of course, and cardiac disease, but how do you protect yourself from hantavirus. And the good news is that you can protect yourself from hantavirus. I said there's a 38% mortality rate once you, you know, once you have the symptoms. But what can you do? Number one, if you see rodent droppings, right, don't sweep or vacuum them. That can spread it in the air and spread the virus in the air, and you can get infected. Instead, spray them with disinfectant, let it sit for 10 minutes, and then wipe it up with gloves and a paper towel. So important to spray with the disinfectant, let it sit for about 10 minutes, and wipe it up with gloves and a paper towel. Then seal up any cracks or holes in your home where mice, you know, may come in, so you keep them out. And also store food in rodent-proof containers, especially in places where they like to hang out. The mice like to hang out in basements and garages, right? If you're cleaning, you know, like an old cabin or places where, you know, this could happen, where you could be in a shed, storage area, wear a mask and ventilate the space first. You don't want to get infected, so it's super important. So these are things you can do to you know, protect yourselves. And remember, the other thing is that we've often talked about, you know, Alzheimer's and heart disease. Remember, Alzheimer's affects more than your memory. It can impact every function in your body. So it's really important to be talking about what you can do with, you know, with your body's gut health and overall approach, right? I think if you avoid processed foods, do more movement, and really watch your both your physical and mental health, you can really, you know, do wonders to try to prevent Alzheimer's. Heart disease still number one killer in the world. I'll tell you, high blood pressure, poor diet, stress, lack of movement all play a role. But good news is preventable. Get your blood pressure checked. Eat real whole foods. Avoid processed foods. Move at least 30 minutes a day. All that will help you. And you know, the other thing I'd like to say is that if you have older parents, grandparents, you have neighbors, friends, just check on them. That's the thing, you know. Maybe if we checked earlier, could have been prevented. Maybe, I don't know, maybe something could have been done. So it's heartbreaking to me that this couple were you know, dead for days before anybody even found them. So kind of a lesson that, you know, if you can try to protect your elderly and try to check in on them as much as you can. You know, so today we found out the cause of the death of Betsy Arakawa. It's a hantavirus, and again, we can do more to protect ourselves from it and learn a little bit more about it. As far as Alzheimer's, as far as heart disease, I think, you know, we've got to do the things we talk about all the time: movement with purpose, better food intake, better spiritual and mental health. And I think we just have to take better care of our elderly. I think it's super important to talk about that. Again, tragedy today, and it was hard for me because, you know, anybody who's been married and has a strong bond with a partner, you can, it's just, it's such a tragedy and so sad to think about what was going on, you know, in, for example, Gene's mind when he saw his wife of over 30 years, you know, passing away. So anyway, I want to talk about that today and see what we can do to hopefully prevent future tragedies. Remember, continue to advocate for your health and be a health hero.